Hello, it's Mark here from Kirklees Visual Impairment Network, where we're always keen to share with you the latest developments in assistive technology. There's been a lot of talk about how accessible the various TV platforms are. We've got something new to share with you, and that's the SkyQ platform and its new voice guidance feature. Let's have a look and see how it works. Well, I've got my SkyQ remote control with me here, and this time I'm going to do something that I've never done before, and that is enable voice guidance. Enable voice guidance. So the first time that I'll know whether it's working is when I press my down arrow, and indeed the keys that I'm going to use throughout this demonstration are those that are in the center of the remote control: the up, down, left and right arrows, and the select button, which is in the centre of those. Let's see how it works.
TV guide. Recordings. Catch up TV. On demand. Sky Cinema. Sky Store. 7 of 14. Press right or select to choose.
Additional information that I'm receiving there is where I am within the menu system. So you heard that I'm on item 7 of 14. And what it's also doing is telling me what actions I can take further, such as pressing the button to select. Let's have a look at one of those menus in a bit more detail, and I'll work my way up to the TV guide.
Recordings. TV guide. 2 of 14, press right or select to choose.
Again, I've got that hint to tell me to press right or the select button to choose. You are able to switch those additional hints off, but we'll mention that a little bit later on.
TV guide, press up or down for different genres. Press left to go back. All channels. 5 of 18, press right or select to choose.
Same principle, I know now that I'm looking at the TV guide by different genres. Moving down.
Catch up. HD. Plus 1.
And back up to all channels.
All channels. 5 of 18, press right. All channels. Press up, down, left or right to navigate through the TV guide. BBC One York's 101. Select to view in Mini TV. Press right for upcoming programmes.
Now I've got a grid layout, and within this what I can find is the different channels by moving up and down, and the different programmes that are on them. I'm on the current programme, so if I wanted to just watch BBC One Live now, I would press my select button. But if I want to find out what's on in the future, I'll just move over to the right. So let's have a listen and see what's on a little bit later today.
Breakfast. Starting morning live. Starts at 9:15 a.m. Duration 45 minutes. Subtitles: Kim Marsh and Gethinger. Homes Under the Hammer. Starts at 10 a.m. Duration 1 hour. Subtitles: Martin Roberts is in Wigan. Frontline Fight Back. Starts at 11 a.m. Duration 45 minutes. Subtitles: 4 tenths. A Brave Mother Fights Back. Paramedics on Scene. Starts at 11:45 a.m. Duration 30 minutes. Subtitles: Audio Description. 9:15. Paramedics respond to a patient with neck pain following a car crash in Livingston and treat a patient who has been coughing up blood. Also in HD, select to choose Paramedics on Scene. Press R to record series, press R again to record once.
So, because I left it on that program, I got a lot more information. Key things for myself is, what is it? When does it start? And really importantly, the fact that it's got audio description. I then get the full program details and information at the end about how I record the program itself, or indeed the whole series. If I press the down arrow, it would take me to BBC Two, so I'd be seeing what's on BBC Two at that particular time. pressing left will take me back.
Home. Breakfast. Started at 6 a.m. Duration, 3 hours and 15 minutes. Subtitles, the latest news, sport, business and weather from the BBC's breakfast team. Also in HD, select to view in Mini TV. Press R to record series, press R again to record once.
Okay, so I'm back at the programme that's currently on the television. A couple of choices available to me now. Again, I can carry on working my way down, or I can go back up to see what other channels are available. Or if I go to my left, it will back me right out of the menu system. So I'll back out of the menu system just for now.
BBC One York TV Guide. Press up. Main menu. Press up or down for different categories. TV Guide. 2 of 14. Press right or select to choose.
And I know straight away that I'm in the main menu once again. Now, I did mention that the box has the ability to switch off those extra hints that you heard me getting as I was moving up and down the menu system. I can action that within the settings menu. I'll work my way down to the settings menu and very quickly demonstrate how that works. I know that the settings menu is quite a good way down, so I can press my down arrow a few times.
Sports. Kids. Music. Apps. Settings.
Select.
Status. Setup. Manual tuning. Setup. Accessibility. 4 of 7. Accessibility. Press up or down for categories. Audio description. If set to on, you'll hear an additional commentary that describes the app. Subtitles. If highlight programs. If set. High contrast. If voice guidance. Supported content on screen will be described audibly. Select with hints to hear extra details. Recommended for new users. Warning, turning this on will turn off Dolby Digital 5.1 audio. 6 of 6. Press right to manage setting.
That's the new item that we've been demonstrating, the voice guidance. As you heard a few moments ago, I switched it on by asking my Sky voice remote to enable voice guidance. If you don't have a Sky voice remote, you can switch it on within the menu system there that we've just heard, although you would need sighted assistance to do that. What I'm going to look at now is how we switch off the hints. Moving to the right.
On with hints, press up or down for options. On without hints, press up or down for options. 2 of 3,
so I've now selected on without hints, and I'm going to back out to the main menu very quickly by pressing the left key. I can also do that with the home button.
Main menu, home. TV guide. 2 of 14. Recordings. 3 of 14.
So you'll hear now all I'm getting is the name of the menu item and where it is within the menu system. I'll just move briefly into recordings.
Recordings, most recent. 1 of 7.
So again, all I'm getting there is the menu item and its position. As the menu information indicated, I think that's really useful once you get yourselves familiar and confident with the different button combinations that you use. So run it with hints off later on, run it with the hints on, which indeed is the default menu at first. Well, that's been our very quick introduction to the new voice guidance that is available on the Sky Q box. It's worth pointing out that Sky are rolling it out across their boxes over the next few weeks. So if your box today doesn't do what mine has done, keep trying over the next few weeks by enabling the voice guidance either with your Sky remote or getting someone to enable it in the menu system for you. And it should work over the next few weeks as they roll this feature out to their boxes. We hope you found this video useful. If you would like to receive more content from us, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, where you can press the notification bell to hear about any new videos that we put out. And don't forget to like the video if you have, because it really does help the channel and other people to find out about content like this. I'm Mark Owen. Thank you very much for watching.